क्लास में हम लोग वेक्टर्स जो अभी तक हम लोगों ने पढ़ा है उसको रिवाइज करेंगे और मल्टीप्लिकेशंस ऑफ टू वेक्टर्स एंड थ्री वेक्टर्स को फर्दर इसको हम लोग आगे बढ़ाएंगे। सो वेक्टर्स रिवाइज कर ले हम लोग, अपने तक क्या पढ़ा, वेक्टर्स क्या है, वेक्टर्स के टाइप्स क्या हैं, हाउ वेक्टर्स आर एडेड, हाउ वेक्टर्स कैन बी सब्ट्रैक्टेड। तो पहले हम लोग सारे से इसको रिवाइज कर ले। सो एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट ऑल फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज इन दिस वर्ल्ड आर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू कैटेगरीज, नंबर वन स्केलर्स एंड नंबर टू वेक्टर्स। स्केलर आर दोज क्वांटिटीज विच हैव मैग्नीट्यूड ओनली एंड वेक्टर्स आर दोज क्वांटिटीज, दोज फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज विच हैज मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन बोथ। एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ स्केलर्स आर मास, वेट, डिस्टेंस। सिमिलरली द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ वेक्टर्स आर डिस्प्लेसमेंट, वेलोसिटी, एक्सेलरेशन, फोर्स एक्सेट्रा। सो स्केलर आर दोज क्वांटिटीज विच हैज द मैग्नीट्यूड एंड द वेक्टर्स आर दोज क्वांटिटीज विच आर हैविंग मैग्नीट्यूड एज वेल एज डायरेक्शन। इन दिस चैप्टर we have discussed about the vectors. So vectors have magnitude as well as direction. So a vector A, if A is a vector, it is represented by vector A, symbol of A, and the arrow sign is placed above the head. So A, vector A, its magnitude is represented by mod of A, which is equal to capital A. So it is vector. Now going to define the addition, that is addition and subtraction of vectors. So it is proof that the simple algebraic law which are applied to the scalars, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, they are not applicable in vectors. There are certain rules which defines their properties and their analytical treatment. So addition of vectors can be done by three laws. Number one is triangle law of vector addition, number two is parallelogram law of vector addition, and number three is polygon law of vector addition. Triangle law of vector addition and parallelogram law of vector addition is applicable for addition of two vectors only, while to add more than two vectors we can use polygon law of vector addition. So let us revise them one by one. So number one is triangle law of vector addition. As the name suggests, there will be a triangle. So it defines as, or it states that if two vectors, vector A and vector B, are represented by two sides of a triangle taken in same order. Same order, that means A to B arrow sign and B to C same size. Two sides of a triangle are represented both magnitude as well as direction by two vectors, then their resultant, that is their sum, is represented by another side or the remaining third side of the vector, that is C is equal to A plus B, taken in opposite order. What is the meaning of opposite order? Opposite order means if we take the same order as we discussed here, that A to B and B to C, that is A to B arrow sign and then B to C arrow sign, if the order is continued, then their sign will be C to A. C to A sign hona chahiye tha. Lekin yahan pe C to A sign na hoke triangle law of vector addition kehta hai ki ye third side ko represent karega A aur B ke addition, lekin kiske order mein? Opposite order mein, A to C. So in this case we have AB plus BC is equal to AC. Or in the short form vector notation, vector A plus vector B is equal to vector C. This is the triangle law of vector addition. Again, if we change the value of A by vector P and vector Q and drop a perpendicular here, this is beta. So this 90 degree, let's say D. So the analytical treatment we have discussed in the earlier lectures, that P, this is R, the resultant is R, then R is equal to root over P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta, where theta is the angle between Q, which makes Q with the P when P is produced further in the x direction or horizontal direction. जब P को हम लोग horizontal direction में आगे की ओर move करते हैं, तो Q angle बनाता है P के साथ में. So this is the value of R, that is root over P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. Similarly, the second law is the parallelogram law of vector addition. The parallelogram law of vector addition is same as triangle law of vector addition. Parallelogram law of vector addition. So parallelogram vector addition says that if there is a parallelogram, if two adjacent sides means the sides having the same common point, if the two sides of parallelogram, adjacent sides of parallelogram represented by two vectors P and Q, both magnitude as well as direction, then their resultant is given by the diagonal, that is AC, of the parallelogram. So as the it is a parallelogram, so the value of P is AB is equal to vector P, so it is also vector P. Q, so it is also vector Q. Let the angle between P and Q is theta, the angle between the angle R, the resultant R makes with vector P is beta. So again, if we say it is the combination of two triangles, agar ye do triangles ke combinations ko represent karta hai, to isme bhi same cheez hoga. R is equal to root over P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. Clear? And this is the parallelogram law of vector addition. So remember, hum log karna hai kya hai ki ट्रायंगल लॉ ऑफ वेक्टर एडिशन और पैरेललोग्राम लॉ ऑफ वेक्टर एडिशन ये दोनों एप्लीकेबल होगा सिर्फ दो वेक्टर्स के लिए, दो वेक्टर्स के लिए हम लोग इसको यूज कर सकते हैं। लेकिन जब दो से ज्यादा वेक्टर्स होंगे तो उस केस में हम लोग ये दो लॉ को यूज नहीं करेंगे, इसके जगह पे हम लोग यूज करेंगे पॉलीगन लॉ ऑफ वेक्टर एडिशन। सो थर्ड इज पॉलीगन लॉ ऑफ वेक्टर एडिशन। पॉलीगन लॉ ऑफ वेक्टर एडिशन कहता है कि पॉलीगन कहने का मतलब ऐसा स्ट्रक्चर जिसमें n नंबर्स ऑफ साइड्स हो, पॉली मींस n होता है। सो अगर हम मान लें कि देयर आर फोर साइड्स और फाइव साइड्स, सो पॉलीगन लॉ ऑफ वेक्टर एडिशन कहता है कि द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ सम ऑफ ऑल वेक्टर्स विल बी द लास्ट साइड ऑफ द पॉलीगन। मतलब कि अगर छह साइड है तो छह साइड में जो लास्ट साइड होगा वो सभी साइड्स के एड के बराबर होगा, दैट मींस नंबर वन, नंबर टू, नंबर थ्री, नंबर फोर, लेकिन लास्ट साइड्स का जो डायरेक्शन होगा वो ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन में होगा। सो लेट्स से दैट इट हैज वन टू थ्री एंड देन फोर साइड एंड दिस इज द लास्ट साइड, सो ए बी सी डी ई, ऑर्डर सेम होना चाहिए चारों का, तो तीनों का पहले हम ले लेते हैं चारों का, ए देन बी टू सी, सी टू डी एंड डी टू डी। लेट वेक्टर ए, ए बी इज डिनोटेड बाय वेक्टर ए, दिस इज वेक्टर बी, वेक्टर सी एंड वेक्टर डी। देन इट सेज दैट द सम ऑफ ए बी सी डी विल बी द लास्ट साइड ऑफ द पॉलीगन इन द रिवर्स ऑर्डर। एरो का से नोटेशन क्या है, ए टू बी है, बी टू सी है, सी टू डी है एंड देन डी टू ई है। अगर ये कंडीशन कंटिन्यू होता है तो ई से ए की ओर जाता है, सेम ऑर्डर, लेकिन पॉलीगन लॉ कहता है कि ये रिवर्स ऑर्डर में होगा और ये साइड जो है डॉटेड पोर्शंस जो हम लोग यहां पर दिखा रहे हैं दैट विल बी इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी प्लस सी प्लस डी। बहुत इजी है, हम लोग इसको सॉल्व कर सकते हैं। अगर हम सी टू ए को मिला दें तो ये एक ट्रायंगल हो गया, देन ट्रायंगल लॉ ऑफ वेक्टर एडिशन सेज दैट ए प्लस बी इज इक्वल टू, दिस इज द रिजल्टेंट ए प्लस बी। नेक्स्ट फिर अगर इसको हम लोग एज्यूम कर दें, यहां पे इसको कंबाइन ज्वाइन कर दें, सो ए प्लस बी और यहां पे सी, सो दैट विल बी इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी प्लस सी। और देन लास्ट ट्रायंगल अगर हम लोग ले, ये एक साइड हो गया, एक साइड हो गया, सो फर्स्ट दिस प्लस दिस और ए प्लस बी प्लस सी प्लस डी। इस तरह से हम लोग नंबर ऑफ एन नंबर ऑफ साइड्स के लिए एडिशन लॉ को अप्लाई कर सकते हैं। दिस इज द पॉलीगन लॉ ऑफ वेक्टर एडिशन। नेक्स्ट वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ वेक्टर्स। Subtraction of two vectors is similar to the triangle law of vector addition. If two sides of a triangle are represented by two vectors, second vector is negative, then their resultant will be the third side of a triangle in the opposite order. So, first, वेक्टर इज वेक्टर p, सेकेंड वेक्टर इज माइनस ऑफ वेक्टर q, सो रिजल्टेंट इज p प्लस माइनस ऑफ q, सो p प्लस माइनस ऑफ q इज सिमिलर टू p माइनस q, सो इट इज द सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ टू वेक्टर्स। नेक्स्ट इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ a scalar to a vector, जब इस स्केलर क्वांटिटी को हम लोग वेक्टर्स के साथ मल्टीप्लाई करते हैं तो क्या होता है. सो इफ ए इज ए वेक्टर एंड इफ इट इज मल्टीप्लाइड विथ एम ऑफ ए देन इट्स डायरेक्शन और इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड विल इंक्रीजेस और इंक्रीज एम टाइम्स एंड डायरेक्शन will be same as vector A. Similarly, if vector A is multiplied with minus of m, then its magnitude will increase m times, but direction will be opposite, since minus sign is there, opposite to vector A. This is the multiplication of a scalar to a vector. Next, we have studied the unit vectors. Unit vector. As the name suggests, unit means one. So, if a vector has a magnitude 1, if the magnitude or modulus of a vector is 1, then vector A is called a unit vector. Also, the unit vector is represented by a cap. So, we call it a cap. And this A cap is also defined as vector A divided by modulus of vector A. That is vector A divided by mod of A, that is A. Therefore, we can write it vector A is equal to A into A cap. This is very important result. That means a vector can be represented by a magnitude of a vector and the unit vector in the direction of vector A. This fact is useful when we study about the resolution or to find the component of vectors in terms of x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. This is the very important result. That is vector A ko hum log magnitude of vectors or a unit vector which is in the direction of vector A can ke respect mein likh sakte hain. The important unit vectors, that is rectangular Cartesian coordinate. Rectangular Cartesian coordinates, that means x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. They are both mutually perpendicular to each other. Mutually perpendicular to each other. What this means? This means that x-axis is perpendicular to y-axis. Y-axis is perpendicular to x-axis, z-axis is perpendicular to x-axis, x-axis is perpendicular to y-axis, also z-axis, y-axis is perpendicular to x-axis and z-axis, and z-axis is perpendicular to x-axis and y-axis. That means तीनों एक दूसरे से perpendicular. So the unit vector which is in the direction of x-axis is represented by small I cap. A unit vector generally in the direction of y-axis is represented as j cap, and the unit vector in the direction of z-axis is represented as k cap. Also, we have to remember that I cap, mod of I cap is equal to mod of J cap is equal to mod of K cap, that they are unit vectors, so the value is 1. So this is the revision of vectors which we have studied in which additions of vectors, multiplication of a scalar to a vector quantity and unit vector. Now, next, we will start a new topic, that is resolution of a vector, how vectors can be resolved in x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. So, the resolution of vectors,
resolution of a vector.
So, what is the resolution of a vector? So, the resolution of vector, that is the process of splitting a vector into two or more than two vectors is known as resolution of a vector. That means किसी भी वेक्टर को दो या दो से अधिक वेक्टर्स में जब हम लोग स्प्लिट करते हैं, तोड़ते हैं, that process is called resolution of a vector. The resolved vectors, जो वेक्टर्स resolved हुए टू में या थ्री में, the resolved vectors are also known as components of a vector. मतलब जो रिजॉल्व हुए दो या दो से अधिक वेक्टर्स में उसको हम लोग क्या कहते हैं, components of vectors. So resolution of vectors में हम लोग को दो पढ़ना है, that is resolution of a vector in rectangular coordinate system in x and y axis, that is 2 axis, and resolution of a vector in 3 component, that is x axis, y axis and z axis. So first we will start the resolution, rectangular of a vector. So the definition says that the process of splitting a vector into two or three vectors in rectangular coordinate system, rectangular coordinate system is known as rectangular resolution of a vector. That means a vector को दो या दो से तीन, maximum 3 axis है, 3 vectors में resolve करने वाले rectangular coordinate system में जब इसको नो resolve करते हैं, that process is called rectangular resolution of vectors. So first we will start case 1, that is rectangular resolution of vectors in 2 axis, that is x and y axis. Case 1, rectangular resolution of a vector into 2 axes or 2 lines. So let there are 2 axes, x axis and y axis, and there is a vector r is there. We have to resolve it into 2 vectors, x-axis, ek vector x-axis or y-axis, do component rectangular hai, that means x-axis or y-axis rectangular, that means they are perpendicular to each other. O is the origin, r is a vector, also we can write it is a position vector. So r is a position vector. Ab is r ko hum log ko resolve karna hai with respect to, मतलब इसको split करना है या in the terms of कितना है x axis और y axis के respect में. So let it is P. From P, let there are two perpendiculars are drawn which meet x axis at M and P y axis at N. Y axis or P axis, x axis or y axis pe PM or PN are perpendiculars. And the angle between vector R with respect to y axis is theta. Angle जो है y axis के साथ में theta है, या फिर assume कर लेते हैं कि vector R makes an angle theta with x axis. Let the resolved path or the value of OM is x and the value of ON is y. Also assume that a unit vector in the direction of x axis is I cap and the unit vector in the direction of y axis is j cap. X axis के रिस्पेक्ट में जो यूनिट वेक्टर है उसको i cap कहेंगे और y axis के रिस्पेक्ट में जो यूनिट वेक्टर है उसको हम लोग j cap कहेंगे. So ये हमारा स्ट्रक्चर है. अब वेक्टर r को हम लोग को x और y axis के रिस्पेक्ट में रिजॉल्व करना है. So first of all OM, the value of OM is x, the value of ON is y. So as we have studied that a vector A or any vector can be written as magnitude of vector A and the unit vector in the direction of vector A. किसी भी vectors को उसके unit vector और उसके magnitude of vectors के product के respect में लिख सकते हैं. So vector OM can be written as modulus of vector OM and the unit vector, which is a unit vector I cap, I cap in the direction of OM. The modulus of OM, that is OM, which is X. So vector OM is XI. Similarly, ON can be written as modulus of ON into J cap. And modulus of ON is Y into J. So it is YJ. Now using triangle law of vector addition, that is in triangle O P O P N, triangle law of vector addition, this is the direction of OM and this is the direction of OP, this is the direction of MP. So, triangle law of vector addition says that if two sides of a triangle taken in the same order, both magnitude as well as direction, then the resultant will be the sum of x and this in the opposite order. So, OP is equal to OM plus P, MP. And OM plus, what is the value of MP? PM is similar to ON. So it is ON. We write it as vector MP is equal to vector ON. Now, what is the value of OP? Vector OP is vector R. So it is vector R. What is the value of OM? Vector OM is XI. So it is X I cap plus ON Y J cap. So here vector R is resolved into the two vectors, that is vector X and vector Y, and it is the rectangular resolution of two vectors in two component, that is vector R jo hai two component mein resolved ho gaya x axis aur y axis ke respect. Again it is a right angle triangle. In right angled triangle OPM, cos theta is equal to base by hypotenuse, that is OM by hypotenuse is OP, and OM is X, OP is R. So X is equal to R cos theta. Similarly, sin theta is equal to MP by OP, that is Y by R. So Y is equal to R sin theta. So vector R can be written as from X R cos theta I cap plus R sin theta J cap, that is taking R as a common, cos theta I plus sin theta J. Also squaring and adding X and Y. So X square plus Y square is equal to R square cos square theta plus R square sin square theta. R square is a common lane, cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1 ho jayega. So it is R square, or R is equal to root over X square plus Y square. So this is the rectangular resolution of a vector into two axes, that is X axis and Y axis. Similarly, in the second case, we are going to resolve a vector into three Cartesian coordinate, that is X axis, Y axis and Z axis. So this is the case 2, the rectangular resolution of a vector into three component, that is X axis, Y axis and Z axis. Or also we can say that a resolution of a vector in a plane. So there is a vector, vector R, and there are three coordinates, rectangular coordinate system, which are mutually perpendicular to each other, the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. A unit vector in the direction of x-axis is i-cap, a unit vector in the direction of y-axis is j-cap, and a unit vector in the direction of z-axis is k-cap. We have to resolve a vector R, which is represented by OP. To make it clear, let draw it a box or rectangular box, or we can say a cuboid in which sides OA, it is represented by X, and the side OC is represented by Y, and side OE is represented by Z. Now using the polygon law of vector addition, that means the last side is equal to the summation of all the other sides. So OP is equal to, using polygon law of vector addition. Okay, हम polygon law कैसे use करेंगे, कैसे यहाँ पे apply करेंगे? So polygon law देखने के लिए हम देखते हैं कि this is the combination of OP is equal to summation of OA, AB, BC, and then the continue. So B to P, OA, AB and BP. A side, A वाला side और A side. So this OP is equal to OA plus AB plus BP. Now, OA, the value of AB, it is rectangle, cuboid hai ya rectangle hai? This side is equal to this side. So, this is AB is equal to OC, and side BP is equal to OE. So, it is OE. Now next we have to find the, this is vector R, OP is represented vector R. OA, this can be written as modulus of vector A and a unit vector. So OA is equal to modulus of OA into I cap, and modulus of A is equal to X. Similarly OC is equal to modulus OC. OC is modulus of OC into the unit vector in the direction of y axis is j cap, so it is yj, and OE is equal to modulus of OE and the unit vector in the direction of z axis is k cap, so it is zk. Therefore, vector R can be written as xi plus yj plus zk. So we have seen here that a vector can be resolved into three component vector in the direction of x axis, y axis and z axis. These are called components of vector R. Xi is the component of vector R, yj is component of vector R, zk is the component of vector R. And this process, whole process is called resolution of vector. Now the next we are going to study about is the multiplication of two vectors. The multiplication of two vectors can be done by two process. Number one is scalar product and number two is vector product. Scalar product means the final result is scalar quantity, while in the vector product the final result is a vector quantity. So let's see it one by one. Multiplication of two vectors. Number one is scalar product or dot product. The scalar product or dot product of two vectors, vector A, if there is a two vector, vector A and vector B making an angle theta, then the scalar product or dot product of two vectors can be given by A dot B, or represented as A dot B, which is equal to modulus of A, modulus of B and the cosine of the angle between them. So here the angle is theta, so the cosine of the angle between them is cos of theta. It is also written as A B cos theta. A dot B is equal to A B cos theta. As we seen that in the final result there is no vector quantity, so it is a scalar quantity. Final result mein koi bhi vector scale notation nahi hai, so it is a scalar quantity. So this is denoted by dot and this quantity is scalar, so it is also called scalar product or dot product. Properties. Number one property is it obeys commutative law. Obeys commutative law. Commutative law means A dot B is equal to B dot A. Order change करने पे value change नहीं करेगा. क्यों? Since we know that A dot B is equal to AB cos theta, and this AB cos theta can be written as BA cos theta. And what is BA cos theta? That is B dot A. So it obeys commutative law. Number two, vector A dot vector A, that will be equal to modulus of vector A, modulus of vector A and the cosine of the angle between them. Two vectors ke beech mein angle kitna banega? 0 degree ka. So it is A into A, cos 0 degree is equal to 1. This is A square. So A is equal to A square is equal to A dot A, or sometimes we can written as A is equal to root over A dot A. Number three is it obeys distributive law. Number three is it obeys distributive law. That means A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C. It always distributive law. Now, the most important thing is, what is the scalar product or dot product of unit vectors? Unit vectors, which we have studied about, that I cap, J cap and K cap. So, it is a rectangular Cartesian coordinate in x-axis. We have I cap, it is J cap and K cap. So, as we know that x-axis, y-axis and z-axis both are mutually perpendicular to each other. Mutually perpendicular to each other का मतलब हो गया कि सभी एक दूसरे के साथ 90 degree के angle होना, मतलब I J के साथ 90 degree angle, J K के साथ 90 degree angle और K I के साथ 90 degree angle. So हमारा definition कहता है A dot B is equal to A B cos theta, where theta is the angle between A and B. So what is the value of I dot I? I dot I is equal to modulus of I and cosine of the angle between I and I. कोई भी वेक्टर अपने साथ कितना डिग्री का एंगल बनाएगा? 0 डिग्री का एंगल. So cos 0 डिग्री. Modulus of I is 1. Modulus of I is 1. Cos 0 degree is 1. So value is 1. Therefore, similar case, I dot I, J dot J and K dot K, the value is 1. But for I dot J, modulus of I, modulus of J and the angle between I and J is 90 degrees, so cos 90 degree. Cos 90 degree is 0, so it is 0. So all the angles which makes other than similar angle, that is I dot J or J dot I, J dot K or K dot I or I dot K, they are 0. So I dot J is equal to J dot I is equal to 0. Again, J dot K is equal to K dot J is equal to 0. And K dot I is equal to I dot K is equal to 0. Matlab, other than this similar angle, wo angle banata hai 90 degree pe. So I ke saath J ka, J ke saath I ka, ya phir ki J ke saath K ya K ke saath, mutually they are perpendicular to each other. So cos 90 degree is equal to 0. So baaki cases mein iska value kya hoga? 0 hoga. Now, if vector A is represented by I into J, A1I plus A2J plus A3K, that is resolved part of vector A in the direction of x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, and vector B is equal to B1I plus B2J plus B3K, then A dot B is equal to, वो जानते हैं, ये इसके साथ मल्टीप्लाई करेगा तो I dot I is equal to 1 होगा, J dot J is equal to 1 होगा, and K dot K is equal to 1 होगा, बाकी apart from this, all the terms are 0, as we know that I dot J, J dot I, J dot K, K dot J, K dot I and I dot K are 0. So A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3, ये final result होगा. So this is the scalar product of or dot product of unit vectors. This result is very very useful. These are required when we solved problems related to them. Next is vector product of or cross product of two vectors. So next is number 2, vector product or cross product of two vectors. So let there are two vectors, vector A and vector B. n cap is the unit vector which is perpendicular to both A and B, and the angle between A and B are theta. So the cross product of two vectors is defined as the modulus of A, modulus of B, and sine A of the angle between them, and the unit vector n cap which is perpendicular to both A and B. So here theta is the angle between A and B, n cap is the unit vector perpendicular to both A and B. दोनों पे ये perpendicular होता है. So this can be written as A cross B is equal to AB sin theta n cap. As in the last term, there is a unit vector, so it is not a scalar quantity, it is a vector quantity. So it is the vector product or cross product of two vectors. Now what are the properties? Properties number one, it does not obey the commutative law, that is A cross B is not equal to B cross A. As we know that A cross B n cap ka direction upar ki or hoga, aur agar B cross A agar lene jaye तो n cap का डायरेक्शन नीचे क्या होगा. डायरेक्शन इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर होता है फैक्टर्स के लिए. सो अगर ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन में है तो ऑब्वियसली इसका वैल्यू माइनस ऑफ n cap होगा. देयरफॉर a क्रॉस b इज इक्वल टू माइनस ऑफ b क्रॉस a. इंपॉर्टेंट रिजल्ट. नंबर टू इज a और सिमिलर स्मॉल a क्रॉस a. वेक्टर ही अपने साथ कितना डिग्री का एंगल बनाएगा? ऑब्वियसली जीरो डिग्री, एंड साइन जीरो डिग्री इज जीरो. सो ए क्रॉस ए इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो इट इज ऑल्सो ए इंपॉर्टेंट रिजल्ट टू सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम. सो ए क्रॉस ए इज इक्वल टू जीरो. नेक्स्ट इज द वेक्टर और क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट ऑफ कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम, दैट इज आई कैप, जे कैप एंड के कैप. सो is Cartesian coordinate system, x axis, y axis, z axis, 0, I, j, k. So first is I cross I, modulus of I, modulus of I, sine of the angle between them is 0 degree, and the unit vector which is perpendicular to both I. So let's say it j. As we know that sine 0 degree is equal to 0, so I cross I is equal to 0. Similarly, J cross J लेंगे तो वहां पर भी sine 0 degree होगा, वहां पर वैल्यू 0. K cross K लेंगे तो वहां पर भी मेरा 0 होगा, तो वहां पर भी 0. So, therefore, I cross I is equal to J cross J is equal to K cross K is equal to 0. Similarly, other than other angles, I dot J, I cross J, that is modulus of I, modulus of J, sine of angle between them, I और J के बीच में कितना डिग्री का एंगल बनेगा? 90 डिग्री का. And the unit vector which is perpendicular to both an I and J is k cap, so it is k. Modulus of I is 1, modulus of J is 1, sine 90 degree is 1, then this is k. So I cross J is equal to vector k. So again, J cross K is equal to I, K cross I is equal to J. इस तरह से हम लोग फाइंड कर सकते हैं. ये रिमेंबर करने का तरीका भी हमारा है कि यहाँ पे I लिखें, यहाँ पे J लिखें, यहाँ पे K लिखें. So I cross J is equal to K, J cross K is equal to I, and K cross I is equal to J. ऑर्डर मेरा ये है क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन में. और अगर ये एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन हो जाए तो उस केस में हो जाएगा J क्रॉस I इज इक्वल टू माइनस ऑफ K, K cross j is equal to minus of I, and I cross k is equal to minus of j. These results are very useful and required in solving the numerical problems. And the last is, if vector A is represented by its resolved component, that is a1i plus a2j plus a3k, vector B is b1i plus b2j plus b3k, then A cross B can be solved using determinant, that is I, j, k, a1, a2, a3, b1, b2. ये सब सारे प्रॉब्लम्स है, हम लोग न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व करेंगे और डिटेल्स में इसको लोग देखेंगे. सो यहाँ पे हमारा कंप्लीट हुआ हमारा मल्टीप्लिकेशन ऑफ टू वेक्टर्स. नेक्स्ट क्लास में हम लोग देखेंगे मल्टीप्लिकेशन ऑफ मोर देन टू वेक्टर्स, दैट इज स्केलर ट्रिपल प्रोडक्ट एंड वेक्टर ट्रिपल प्रोडक्ट. एंड लास्ट है वेक्टर्स का रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी, तो दो वेलोसिटीज का रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी कैसे हम लोग फाइंड कर सकते हैं. और इसी क्लास में फिर हम लोग जो बाकी समराइज किए सारे समराइज करने के बाद फिर हम लोग प्रॉब्लम डिस्कस करेंगे. न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन फिजिक्स. विदाउट न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम फिजिक्स इज यूजलेस. सो पहले हम लोग न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम को सॉल्व करेंगे करके इंपॉर्टेंट जो न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम होगा. देन फिर हम लोग मोशन इन वन प्लेन के चैप्टर्स में मूव करेंगे और वहां पे फिर एक एक करके आगे के चैप्टर्स को डिस्कस करेंगे.